Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome back to Farming Simulator 17. I was just unloading this trailer here. I noticed something kind of fun. Am I lined up? Yeah. As I was putting the seeds in, I'll show you. I was driving them through here. Let me back up a little bit. And all of the sowers came to life. As I get close, it pops the lids open. They are anticipating being fed, like little baby chick mouths popping open when mama bird comes back with a worm. All right, we're gonna, trying to move my view here. You go that way, you go down. Like that. Boy, it's hard to do this inside here. There we go. Now I can see what I'm doing. About like so. Well, you're smashed in as you're going to go. All right. So down. Tilt. Can I slide out? Yeah. Okay. You're done. Let's get this last one out of here. Oops. Bumped something. Trying to stay out of the roof. Alright, something like that. You want to be about there. Alright. I like that. Even with this weight on the back, it still tips the tractor forward. Something like that. No. Come on now. Play nice. Wow. Come on, let go. There's definitely still some issues with the way the fork of the front loaders work. You will not let go, will you? Let go. Okay. We'll do it this way. All right. Made it work. Okay. Anyway, let's go drop off this weight. And we'll back up the trailer. Yeah, it seems like as good a place as any. Forward. Let's see, that is G to that one. V. And Q. Yeah, may as well drop this guy off. Well, no, we'll keep that. No, I'll take that back. I'm very indecisive today. We need the bale fork, I am guessing. So we haven't shifted over yet, have we? Growth? No, we're still where we were. Okay, so I'm thinking we'll go ahead and grab another hay bale and make another load of TMR over there for the cattle. There we go. So, G and Q. Let's pick this guy up. Rather than drive the Manitou all the way back. Right there. To the sheep to pick it up, then go back over there again. Might consider just leaving this guy over there. We'll see. Just like this. Up, Whoa, trying to do too many things at once with the same mouse. There we go. Now, boy, that's right in my face. Anyway, fun part. So if I were to kick him that way just a little, that's a little too much. See if I can recuperate from that. You know, I could be there for 10 minutes lining that up. I can go around the corner here and it's so much faster. Alright. Right one selected? Yeah. Alright, we'll do that. Kind of a cleanup episode, I'm kind of guessing. Unless the crops pop over there and give us something exciting to do. Right about there. Let's go put this guy away. Long ago, when this game just came out, I was watching Daggerwind, and he was talking about selling off this tractor because of the high maintenance hours on it. And let's see, put that down there. As soon as we can drop this off, I'll pop into the next screen and show you some things about how that works. Alright, something like that. But where is that? Vehicle overview? Yeah, that's this guy. What am I looking at here? I want the Case IH 14, this guy right here. 77 days. Where's the other case? That's not him. Must be further down. It is all the way down here. Okay. So it's odd that they are registering it in days here, but in the tractor it's registered in hours. I wish they used the same scale so you can keep track of what's going on. But anyway, the one, there's $1,000 a day maintenance. This other one was only $133 a day maintenance. Okay. So this is costing us $1,000 a day to have this tractor, which 51 hours of running time on the engine. Now, of course, everything is exaggerated in Farming Simulator 17. 3 days, you have a whole season, you know, like 3 months worth of growth. So if a month is a day, then, you know, that 50 hours, maybe it's more like 500 hours or 5,000 hours. But the point is, it's costing us a lot to still have in our arsenal. But if we sell it, we're going to get $10,000. It's costing us $1,000 a day. If we jump over to the store, which I can't do from here. There we go. What's it cost to buy another one? That is the Case 1455. It's in the 145 horsepower range, so it's actually a decent tractor as far as capability. Oh, I don't have it clicked. That's not it. There it is right there, 145. So 102,000, we're going to get back about 10, so 92,000. So we're going to have to spend $92,000 to save $1,000 a day. Or rather, in 90 days, we would have broke even. You know, so it takes an awful lot to actually lose, unless that $1,000 escalates and goes higher and higher. That I don't know. I don't know if there is a ceiling and we've hit it or not. If it stays at $1,000 a day, it's going to take 92 days just to break even on this deal. To me, that feels like you may as well just, you know, keep the tractor you've got. But what I'm talking about or thinking about is whether or not we want to just park this guy over there at the cattle. Let's drive over there. And just use him to move bales around in the for the total mixed rations and that sort of thing. In Farming Simulator 2013, it came with an old-fashioned tractor, baler. There was a third implement. What was that one? Sower. That looked like it was from the 1940s, maybe. It looked like it was quite antique, and it would, had hardly any power, and it's not something that you could really use for doing a whole lot. It was more just for the nostalgia of having it. But when you hooked the water tank to it and moved it around for your greenhouses and your animal pens, it worked great. So I'm kind of thinking this is the kind of tractor we might just park somewhere and just use once in a while, like we were using the Manitou over here. Just use it once in a while to clean up the feed area. So I'm kicking that one around. The one advantage to selling it is we could get $10,000 off of our next tractor. But to save $10,000 on that tractor, we lose the advantage of a fifth tractor here that would cost another $92,000 to buy the same thing. So I don't know that that's really what I want to do. You see what I mean? That's my logic, at least. I'm going to sneak in here and grab two bales, about like that. Hello. How you doing? All right, let's go up a little higher and aim for there. Let's grab this guy. All right, boom. I guess I got it. Back up a little, lift, tilt, a whole bunch. We're still free of the roof. And that beam, yeah. And the post. Whoa. Okay. Let's get off the caffeine and just touch the pedals, not stomp them. Let's take this higher. It doesn't tilt any higher. We'll just... Let's see, that's like that and that. All right. Let's see what it's like to drive this thing across town. Little tippy. Whoa. Anyway, let's go drop this into the mixing wagon. And we'll be able to top off the cattle over there while we're waiting for the grass to mature or do something else. I didn't get my time going up again. There. 5-speed. I always set it on to 1 when I turn the game on, so I've got little time to move around from tractor to tractor and kind of look the map over and figure out what exciting thing can be done. And there wasn't a whole lot of excitement in what I found today. So maybe time will advance enough. Wow, that is really rocking. Advance enough to be able to get in some mowing or something. Fertilizing, that's probably one of the next jobs to do once the fields transition over. Okay, we're clear here. In order to run the pedals, was it this one? I think it was this one. I have to take my shoes off, because when I'm using with my shoes on, I can't feel the pedals enough to figure out which one I'm on. It doesn't have the same feel as a real car. They're a little plasticky, and the springs aren't the same kind of tension, so it just works a lot better with my shoes off. And I'm just noticing I've got a hole in the heel of my sock. It's bugging me. Anyway, a little too much information there. Let's move on to our mixing wagon. There we go. That corn... Whoa! That was a little exciting. Gravity-defying there. Let's leave him attached. Another reason why I'm thinking about this over here is I can't move those guys with the Manitou because they require PTO. They have the exact same hitch, but because there's no power takeoff, it will not interact with them, which is annoying. I wish it would. Even though you wouldn't be able to run them, at least you could move them from place to place. So I'm going to need a real tractor left over here. That's my thought. Right there. Grab him. Pull him out. And... Let's take him around something like this. Alright. Because I need to get in and around these other things, too. Now, it's two of these, one of those, and one of those. So we can just drop these in. It could also be one of these, two of those, and one of those. For that matter, let's store one. That way we don't have to make this trip again if we haven't made hay before the next time we need this. We have lots of silage bales sitting over here. So let's drop you guys. You gonna play nice now? You are. Okay. Yeah, that one pallet did not want to let go. Alright, grab you. Lift you up. I think I am sitting too close to the pedals. I seem to be leaning on them and taking off much faster than I used to. There we go. A little more control that time. Oh, hello. I found the mixing wagon. Are you in the air? You're over here. And let's... This one's real sensitive. You just kind of get it close and tip it down and it just swallows it. Boom. Now, I wish that that wouldn't do that. I wish you had to actually turn it on to activate it. It just seems... I don't know, it just doesn't seem right to have it without the power take off attached, and suddenly it's running. Alright, you... There we go. No, back up. Now we're happy. That's right, we're going to use two of these. My app. A little more. Okay, one more. See if I can grab that top one from here. About there, straight in. Nope, hitting a wheel. Okay. That wheel's still going to go into there. Okay, we're going to grab it with only one tine. How does that sound? Yeah, we seem to be squeezing in there. And it seems to be handling it. Okay. Grab a hay bale. I know where those are stored. What's the chance I can grab that one without knocking the other one out? Okay, height. Going for there. Down. Over the top of that front one. It's about like that. Okay. And I gotta come in more from the side. Well, that's clear, but from here it looks like it's going to hit. Now we're going to hit the wheels. How best? I guess we've got to drag this guy out. Maybe it wasn't the best idea to store those there. Alright. You know, if I bang them back and forth, will they settle in? Not really. Okay, you're there. Q. Let's run the circle here and grab that guy again. Yeah, it looks like I'm grabbing the back one now. Well, it was further off than I thought. Okay, you go down a lot lower. There we go. Tip, and yeah, it looks like everything's settled in the shredder now. All right. There we go. Seems like it was 120 hours for the next cow. The reproduction rate. I'm curious if everything is maxed out, what that drops down to. One of the reasons I wanted to come back here and do this. Get in a little closer. Assuming that it's still set to dump on the same side. Let's get a little closer. There we go. Everything is within acceptable margins there. Turn on, apparently, oh, there we go, left side. Interesting. So, I know I didn't change that, so I guess it defaults to the left side every time you turn the game on. Okay, so it says to turn on, but also says to unload. Do I even need to turn it on? Let's just unload, see what happens. Okay, I hit the wrong one. Let's try the I for unload, not the U for unload. Oh, I wonder what language they programmed that in. Yep, we're unloading. So if I were to shift over to here and go to animals, it's increasing right there. And real time, too. So a little cleanliness, and we're fine. Next animal in 95 hours now instead of 120. Reproduction rate is 100 hours. Ah, okay, there we go. And it was 120 hours before. Okay. So pop out of that. And I did not turn it on, so I don't need to turn it off. So we just go put this guy away, park the other one, and we're done here. It's 6 p.m. now, so let's, after we've done all this, we'll see if the map is, if any of the crops have updated. No, I'm going to the other bay, that's right. I don't talk much when I'm concentrating. Making things go backwards, mirror image, is something I've got to think about. Kind of hurts the brain. Yeah, something like that. They're not even, but they're straight. That counts. Alright, we're done here. We're done here. Let's park this guy here. I'll tell you what, let's do this first. Map. There we go. Growth. We have not moved. So when these guys go to the darkest green, we'll be at the next stage. I'm pretty sure that's where they were before, although these have changed. I think that's where they were. All right, we're gonna work with that. So in that case, let's grab this water, get out of the ceiling here, and let's go find a place to fill it up. That ought to be quite exciting. Where to? Let's go this way. There was a beach over by Mary's farm. It'd be great if we can find something a little closer than that. But we are definitely going to need to fill this guy soon. He's It's got just enough left to top off one of the animals, and that's all. Alright, everything over here is a sheer drop-off. There's a potential spot, but that's still really steep across the river there. Yeah, so if it's any kind of realistic, that's where we need to go. Right over there at the sandy beach area. Okay, we're going there. Though this tractor may have a little trouble getting it out of the water. This is the little guy. Well, the medium guy. Put it that way. The New Holland, the blue one, that's the little guy. Alright, best tactic. I'm thinking right over there where it gets kind of blurry. That's about as far as I want to go. R? Yeah. There we are. I'm creeping in. It's getting heavier. Okay, can it pull us out of here? Ugh. Wow, that is struggling. There we go. Come on, you can do it. Yeah, we're happier. So soon, I need to dive into this field here and get it plowed. Get a little extra money in the bank. I guess that's not too big. It's probably a half hour's worth of work there. Yeah. Trying to think what else to do. Maybe I will just go ahead and do that job there, and I'll pop back in when the timer moves across the into the next growth stage, and we've actually got something interesting to do. Let's back this guy in and call this done. Just a quick little maintenance episode is kind of what this turned out to be. Guess we'll just call that one done. Let me check the map one more time. Yeah, we're still not in that stage yet. What is? You know, I can't tell. Is that the dark green or is it the medium green? It may have shifted. You know, I kind of think it did. So next time, we'll dive into fertilizing this, fertilizing that, and then that's probably the end of the day. I would think so. And then the next morning, we'll either be harvesting these guys or we'll be mowing and silaging, I'm guessing, the rest of this. So that may be the plan. We'll see how that goes. Anyway, this has been Noble Rambler. Thank you guys for watching, and subscribe and like if you would. I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.